barbers, you know, I think we need to get back to just, you know, establishing what I call that familyhood with people. I feel we just built that unity right there, and I think a lot of barbers need to really tap back into that instead of just, you know, taking care of the clients, one thing, but just finding out about how the client's family doing or letting that client get a chance to vent, you know, because barbers, we, you know, we're almost like the Dr. Phil's and the Dr. Oz's of hair. One of my dreams is to, you know, have everybody tap into that inner Dr. Oz or that inner Dr. Phil and, you know, be more than just, you know, cutting that client's hair. Just, you know, be like part of the family. And that's why a lot of people, Lauren, even to this day, they look at, you know, Zarif and it's like, well, how did the president able to be with this guy for like almost 20 years, not 20 years. They built that familyhood because even I remember the days even when President Obama was coming here, he would always ask about how his grandchildren are doing, how the kids are doing, or it just comes from them, you know, just building that familyhood for so many years. And I feel like that right there should be not only an example, but that should be motivation, you know, with each client you have, because you know that client could become the next president or that client could be doing some real powerful stuff, and they always gonna pull you because guess what? You're part of the family now.